Today I have the Eckerd group coming in, and they're going to be performing a training tactic that massively impacts on-field baseball performance that you probably aren't doing. Stay tuned, check it out. Okay, so we are talking about deload. Yes, deload, you've probably heard of the term or you've seen it in your training program, and I bet you skipped right over it and headed straight into the next block. However, the science massively supports it, and I know firsthand anecdotally just how important and how beneficial a deload block can be in a training cycle. So what is deload? It's a period of time that you reduce the volume and intensity of workouts. Typically, this is about 1 week's worth of training. Depending on the coach in sports performance training, this can be on week 4, week 5, or week 6 of a training cycle. For me personally, I like a deload week to land on that 5th or 6th week because I do block periodization. So say we have a 14-week program. That's broken down into 3 different blocks. On the first 3 weeks or 4 weeks, we'll work on one training adaptation, and then that following week will be the deload week. And then you just repeat that cycle throughout the entire 14-week program. So why is deloading so beneficial in our sport? Because it promotes recovery and restoration, and it recovers the central nervous system and prepares it for that next block of training. All the anaerobic power training baseball players do, you need to give the central nervous system a rest. If you're go, go, go all of the time, week by week, you're most definitely going to hit a plateau in your training. So by fluctuating training stress, the body receives a new stimulus. That new stimulus jumpstarts the training adaptation in that next block. This is going to make sure you optimize the strength, speed, and power gains within that next block of training. So a little disclaimer, there's a lot of strength coaches out there that do not believe in adding deload into the training. However, the science does in fact prove them wrong, and with a sport like baseball, the majority of training is anaerobic power training. This type of training puts a high demand on the central nervous system, so the CNS most definitely needs a break. Firsthand within this gym, I've seen how important adding a deload week into training can be with my guy Evan Blum this summer. He was at 88 miles an hour for 3 straight weeks, so we decided to take a deload week, and then that following week, he rose up to 92 miles an hour on his pulldowns. Just by adding that deload week into the training, he was able to increase his throwing velocity 4 miles an hour, breaking through those training plateaus from block 1. So as I said before, I have the Eckerd boys in here today, and they just happen to be on week 6 of their program. So here we're going to show you an inside look at a deload week for these Eckerd baseball guys. We're a little banged up today. We're bringing the volume and intensity down a little bit this week so we can recover, restore the body for the next block of training next week, all right? All right, so first one, we're gonna do these little multi-directional hops. Super low intensity, just working through the ankle. So the first one is here. You're gonna shoot out laterally, come back and get up in the air, and then shoot back laterally, come back and get out of the air. All right, so it's gonna be like this. Shoot out. All I wanna do is ball, put my money over bitches, put my hustle over all, Louis down to the draw. Now I'm going to move these out a little. Now you're going to get a little more aggressive with it. I'm the marathon man, all I do is run shit. A sophisticated convict, superficial, still official, multi-million dollar shit. Money is the object. Alright, now we're going to pop nice easy through the ankle, but keep intensity a little bit higher this time. Alright, so we should have went like 50%, 75%. Now I'll go closer to 90, 100 for the 15 seconds. I'm done moaning, you dream back at your dream, bitch, in your dream house. Only passing them beans out with a bag through the whole team hat. Gone, boy, get seen back. Bro, you know. So for the deload, listen, we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G. All right, all of these movements, we're going to roll through them one time for the movement prep. All right, this is more like flow state stuff, polishing up the hip joint, all that jazz. And then we're going to go into the lower portion, which is gonna be a lower lift. We're gonna hit trap bar deadlift at 50% on one rep max. We're gonna do 3x3 there. hit some buddy hamstrings, low volume, low intensity, and then a couple more movement patterns, three-way lunge with the monster walk with the bands, and you guys are gonna foam roll, Mark Pro, and get out of here, all right? Let's hit it. So low hip shift, remember, just get under it, super wide and slow, back, step through, four total times, all right, each side. Now we're going landmine frog rocker. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna go leg out to the side. You're gonna keep the landmine tucked under your chin. You're gonna sit your hips back. Try to put your butt cheek on the heel, down, and then pop your hip up through. All right, so hinge down, pop the hip up through. So working through end range of motion like this, that's how you gain true mobility. It's not your static stretching. The research says in order to gain lengthness at the muscular level, pull on the tendons to decrease your true muscle tightness, you gotta hold a stretch for like 30 or so minutes. We don't have time for that, so we'll hit our controlled articular rotations, get that hip joint nice and loose, and that's how they're gonna gain that end range mobility. All right, just the cars that we do, you know, every week, but I want you guys super strict with them today. So I don't want you guys like leaning, I want you guys locking the pelvis in, pulling that belly button under and up all the way around. I don't have it, but these guys do. Get it. Don't sniff J, but I blow drone. Bank roll on loco. Steer ride with that fofo. Don't let my PO know. Bad white bitch, super thick. I'm iced tea, she Coco. She got another bitch, them other bitch. Her ass fat face so so. No paper trail, no phone call, no emails. No. All right, next one. Banded TKE around the back of the knee. Attach it to the back of the knee. Front leg, you're going to be like a pogo. All right, on the one side. And all you're gonna do is line this toe up with the heel, and you're just gonna contract the hamstring, pull it through, nice and easy. Extend the leg, up on the toe, pull down through the heel. Up on the toe, pull down through the heel. Low blow hit, but since slow mo. Hey, purple label, polo and a cool, that's all I do. Man, I strive to roll my denim in the new Margiela shoe. Man, we be cool and we jet pilot. Oh, margarita, molly, and the stronger pack around. Up and shot they out now. So we are going to do a strength movement today. However, it's at RPE, so rate of perceived exertion. So not a true one rep max. It's going to be 50% of your RPE. So however you think, hey, you think you can hit 400 pounds, we're gonna load 200 pounds on a bar. Moving it relatively fast, super low intensity, right? We kick it how we kick it. No, you give it how I'm living. JJ can't resist it. Pimpin', get the million by my business. Bro, you know me, you know I be. Stacking that dough, that's all I see. IGOGETID. Grind won't stop. Hustle won't quit. Shine like no other I be. Hey, so all you guys are getting these hamstring injuries at school. So I am gonna add a little eccentric with the hamstring here. So it's just a, basically a buddy hamstring curl on the pad though, so you don't have to hold each other. And you can use the band assist to assist you back up if you need to, right? If I don't get all I gotta do it, go. You guys are going to utilize a kettlebell. We're going to do a three-way lunge here. I'm holding a kettlebell right here. Bang. Forward. Back. Side. All right, boys, putting the bands on. Finishing up with monster walk series. You're going to go down and back 15 yards. And then you're gonna do that two more times, all right? That's all I do. Man, I strive to roll my denim in the new Margiela shoe. Man, we be cool and we jet pilot. Oh, margarita, molly, and the stronger pack around. Up and shot they out and now we menage for a hobby. The idea is if I were to deadlift 500 pounds for two reps, or I would deadlift, you know, half of that for five. Obviously, the heavier deadlift is going to be more strain on the central nervous system. So what we do is we just cut all that in half, right? So this is kind of the finisher, rather than loading the back with a barbell or loading with heavier dumbbells. This will be the type of finisher, more of a body weight with the bands. Sure, it's gonna burn, fire up the glutes and hamstrings. However, it's gonna be less strain on that nervous system to promote recovery for next week when we get into another phase. All right, boys, that's a wrap. Go ahead and hit the foam roller for like 15, 20 minutes before you leave. Work out the hamstring. You got a little kink in your hamstring. Sit on it for a while. Quads, IT band, everything, lower back. And then if you guys want, I'll give you the Mark Pro. Any of you guys want the Mark Pro? All right, you want the Mark? Priorities. And then this week would be a good week to get a massage, right? You know, the deload week, get all the soft tissue going, promote recovery that way. Yeah, make sure you guys are eating good meals too this week. Hey, at the end of the day, nobody's grinding like us, man. Everything I do, I be tipping the head. My young ain't got nobody, she's the piss in the bed. Keep the call to silence, don't repeat what I said. Welch sets one down the line and left.